excitement. The 30th birthday of Coronation Street. Amongst others, there's Amanda Barry, Jill Summers, better known as Phyllis. Helen Worth, who plays Gail Tilsley. And Lynn Perry, Ivy Brennan. Lindsay King, Gail's daughter, Sarah Louise. Stuart Wolfenden there, better known as Mark Casey. And Liz Dawn, who's Vera Duckworth. Warren Jackson, Sue Nichols and Mark Eden. Brian Mosley there with his wife. And Bill Waddington, accompanied by Cheryl Murray, who was Susie Birchall. The lovely Anne Kirkbride. And Charles Lawson, who are all here to say, Happy Birthday, Coronation Street.
It's raining down sorrow, nothing but bad news. You know I've had it up to here, living with these blues. But I won't let it get me down, it's not the only game in town. You and I, we're going to Swing Street. Can dance there, there's a chance there of finding a little romance there. You don't know who you'll meet when you're down on Swing Street. Lose the blues in a minute, cop the groove and you're in it. I'm telling you once, telling you twice, better take my advice. If you're weeping and you're wailing, I got a cure to fix exactly what is ailing. Count to four and take my hand. Say I'll meet you by the band. You and I, we're going to Swing Street. Just reach out and take my hand, and I'll meet you by the band. You and I, we're going to Swing Street.
For this special evening, Cilla Black.
Thank you very much. Hello. Welcome to the party, isn't it wonderful? Coronation Street's 30 years old today. The most popular show in Britain. Top of the ratings for as long as anyone can remember. It's your favourite and it's certainly mine. I never miss it and that's why I'm so thrilled to be here. You know, I grew up at this street. Do you know, I was only just 5 years old when it started. Oh yes, I was. Oh yes, I was. All right, call me a liar for 12 years. But oh, I remember that first episode so well. There was Ken's dad mending a puncher in the front room, and my dad was doing the very same thing in our front room. And just look at this set, isn't this fabulous? Yeah. Yes, look at that. And what about these ducks up here? Oh, wait. Yes. Well, that's much better. I don't know about you, but the earth has just moved for me. Hey, I say, we've got a great show for you. Back there waiting to come on are some faces from the past you'll all remember and some surprises you'll hardly believe. Weatherfield's never been so excited. And just think, 30 years of the street. Think about that. That's 3,157 episodes, 1,000 miles of videotape. And that's a lot of videotape. And we've taken those 30 years and squeezed them into just 3 minutes. Oh, nostalgia, here we come.
I'm Mrs. Sharples.
I'm very pleased to meet you.
My niece.
Anybody at home?
Well, I enjoyed it. I thought it was quite a nice affair.
Affair? Now what happened?
No, but it was very lively.
I suppose with a woman as beautiful as you are, I'm always going to have rivals. So I'll just have to fight them off, won't I?
Go! Go!
And take it!
You animal!
That's about it now, isn't it?
Yes, I think that's everything.
Great stuff, isn't it? Now, there's someone sitting in the audience who's been with the street since day one. Our very own Ken Barlow. Where are you, Ken? Where are you? Oh, there he is, Chuck. Look at that. Now, Ken, I don't know whether you realise this, but you've had a girlfriend every 18 months for the past 30 years. How do you do it, Chuck? Not a lot of... Oh, yes, a lot of fun. I've got a message out here for Warren Beatty. If you're watching out there, Warren, eat your heart out. But, Ken, have a look at this clip from 1973. See if you recognise and remember one of the girls who got away.
Well, just before the phone rang, I was going to say something. It was a declaration.
Ken, please don't.
Yes, I'm in love with you.
Have you thought about what you're saying?
Oh, yes, I've thought about it. I've thought about lots of things. That I love you.
Oh, yes. I love you too, Ken, I do. Who else could that be but Joanna Lumley? Joanna, so you did it. You turned him down. You turned R. Ken down. How could you do it?
I know. I don't know how I did it.
Well, what was going through your head at the time?
Well, I don't know. I was sort of planning to go off to Brussels, and so I said no to him, and I've never stopped regretting it. You know? I mean, he was just so stunning and so mean and moody and everything. And,
ooh!
And I got letters from all over England saying I was a complete fool.
Well, you were. You were a fool to yourself. I mean, this... All this could have been yours, Joanna. Mind you, history has gone the full cycle for you, hasn't it?
I know, it's rather strange, because in real life I am in fact Mrs. Barlow.
Yes. And Mrs. Stephen Barlow, you're married to the great conductor.
Yes, I am.
Oh, well, it's lovely to see you back on the street where you belong, Joanna. Oh. Enjoy the rest of the evening.
Yes.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Joanna Lumley. I should have rephrased that. Sorry, Joanna, I could have rephrased that better, couldn't I? I mean, you know, back on the street where she belongs. Sorry about that, Chuck. But you see, I'm 5 minutes back up north, it all comes out, I'm sorry. But I must tell you, we have some guests with us tonight who weren't actually in the street, but who are great fans of the show. Like this next young man, who was just 3 years old when the street first started. And tonight, he brings a touch of real magic to Weatherfield. Ladies and gentlemen, Wayne Dobson.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, well, you've seen Uri Geller, who was going to be with us tonight, but he washed his neck and his head fell off. Could have been worse. And you've seen him do mind reading. Well, tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present to you the world's only mind reading budgie. This is Harry, who's been concentrating for the last 40 minutes, by the look of things in there. And what I need two people to help with this from the audience. And I think the gentleman there and the lady there would be marvellous. Give them a big round of applause. Would you do that for me? Over here. And good evening, sir. Thank you very much indeed. And your name is?
Thelma.
Hello, Thelma. And your name is?
Peter.
Pete. That's just a posh name for manure. And Pete, this is Harry, the mind-reading budgie, who you've never met before. No. Well, how do you know it's him? This is a great trick. This is a deck of cards. I know because I was that soldier. And prior to the show starting, the budgie here had a premonition. Now, he liked it that much, when it wore off, he had another. What we're going to do... Is this a normal deck of cards?
I think so.
It is? Yes. Okay. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to run my thumb down the side of the cards. When you get the urge to say stop, you must say stop. Which is silly, really, because if you got the urge, why the hell would you say stop? Now, are you ready for this?
Stop.
You must be quicker than that, okay? This time. Ready?
Stop.
No, haven't started. Even easier. I'll just say stuff at any time. Okay, you want that there?
Yes.
Okay, now if you had that card there, I'd see it. So take the one we don't see. Have a look at it, remember it, show it around to the audience. Would you do that for me? And show it to the camera there. In that way I can see it on the monitor over there. That's great. Now, if you... I'm joking. Now, are you ready for this?
Yes.
Good. Now, you okay?
Yes. Yeah.
Nothing wrong?
No.
Yeah. Can you hear that?
Yes.
Now, this is... What I'd like to do is place your card back in the deck just there. That's good. We'll do that. What I'm going to do is this. Will you take the cards in your hand like that, Peter? That's it, in the spring position. And what's going to happen is an amazing thing. Would you like to see the world's fastest trick? Yeah. Would you like to see it again?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, this is the trick. Ready for this? What's going to happen is you're going to spring the cards in the air. The budgie will fly out, catch the card in its mouth, and fly back to the cage. It's a brilliant trick. As soon as you're ready, the card's in the air, and he will do it, okay? Just spring them like that, okay? Ready for this? Because it's brilliant. As soon as you're ready, in the air, he'll do it. Out, by the way. It's a great trick. But don't worry, because here is a prediction that he made earlier. Inside there is one card and one card only. What was the card that you chose?
The three of diamonds.
The three of diamonds. This budgie is incredible because what he did was he took one off there and bit it out and there we have the three of diamonds. Now, we'll try. You're doing so well. We will try one more experiment. I have here some luggage labels to various parts of the world. They're from Gilroy Travel. They're marvellous. Now, they go to various parts of the world. We have here Madeira. You'd like to go there? I know. Now, this is Istanbul and Paris and Madrid and various ones, okay? What we're going to do, Peter, what I want you to do is this. I would like you to just take the end of any luggage tag and just pull it out. Any one that you like. The luggage tag, that is, okay? Now, this is it. I'm going to take a look at that. Can I take a look at that? We'll show it to the camera there, which is Rome. Okay? Could I know that you were going to choose Rome? No. This is Rome. Brilliant, this. The budgie made a prediction. You may be saying, how can a budgie make a prediction? Well, prior to the show starting, we fed the budgie on a vindaloo curry, prune juice, and put this under his perch for 10 minutes. And there, in his own handwriting, is Rome. Now, this, you worked so well, Harry. And as a souvenir of the occasion, Peter and Thelma, come out here. Come out. He's great. I'd like you to take this home with you. Please. Yeah. And I think you've been a marvellous sport. Thank you very much indeed. Thanks a lot. Okay? Thank you very much. Thanks. Okay? Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Okay? And thank you too.
Oh, wasn't that great? And were Peter and Thelma good too? Well, our next surprise guest first appeared in Coronation Street 20 years ago. He went on to become one of television's greatest and bravest war heroes. Now see if you can recognise him through a rather thin disguise.
Nurse! Excuse me, nurse, I wonder if you could render some assistance. The woman's just fainted.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Gordon Kaye! Gordon, welcome to Coronation Street's birthday. Now, they were absolutely gobsmacked out there because they didn't recognise you till that very end, that close-up.
Well, it was 20 years ago. I was thinner then and a bit more hair as well, but...
But you never played a nurse in Coronation Street.
No, well, only on that occasion, yes. I was Bernard Butler, who was Elsie Tanner's nephew.
Really?
Yes. Yes, but I was thinner, I did have more hair.
And you look gorgeous even now.
Oh, you're very
And
kind.
Now you're in Hello,
That's
of our
right, yes,
favourite TV
yes,
shows.
Well, it's great to be back at Granada, and you've been saying funny things about the weather that we've got here today. Yeah. It is a bit cold. But I remember the last time I worked here at the end of the street, and as I was leaving, somebody said, yeah, blooming cold day before we have him back again. I knew it was going to be like this. But...
Actually, Gordon, I was wondering, I mean, what would René say if he was in the street? What would he say tonight?
I suppose he would say that you are probably wondering what René is doing at the 30th birthday of this wonderful, wonderful show. Well, I am here to give the evening something of a continental touch. And if there is anybody out there who would like a continental touch,
It is a great pleasure, and on behalf of all of us at Café René, may I wish all these wonderful people and all the wonderful viewers a very happy 30th birthday for Coronation Street.
Great. Ladies and gentlemen, Gordon Kaye. Well, who knows, one day we may see Gordon back in the street now. Wouldn't that be great? Yeah. Yes, of course. Well, still to come on the show, more surprise party guests and a lot more fun.
Even though Ramsey Street is 11,000 miles away, we still feel like your neighbours. Congratulations, Coronation Street, on your 30th birthday.
Well done.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Well, Ethel, you know what they say?
What?
The first 30 years is the worst.
I'm looking forward to the next 30.
Happy birthday, Coronation Street!
Oh, that's lovely. And a very big thank you to everyone at Albert Square. Hello and welcome back. Now, I've always watched the street, and so have my kids. In fact, we've all grown up with it. Our Jack loves Jack himself. Oh, Jack. In fact, a little personal message from my little one. He wants to know, when are you going to get your glasses fixed? Oh, well, keep up the good work. We all love you, as well as our Jack. Anyway, we thought it would be fun to ask a few of its youngest fans what kind of impression the street has on them.
Do 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 do. Do 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 do.
Coronation Street is a funny thing, funny film, and it's full of laughs.
Oh, shut up!
Lewis is a chatterbox. Because she always speaks a lot.
Well, I really don't know.
Don't really know.
Phyllis always says to Persa, do you want a cup of tea and a
book? Percy.
Sally's having a baby. She's married to Kevin. Kevin's very surprised.
When it starts and the way it goes, don't know how the cat knows how to act.
Happy birthday, Coronation Street. Hope you have a lovely time.
Happy birthday, Coronation Street!
Birthday smashing. And what about that little Phyllis? Oh, Phyllis, we have got to see her just one more time.
Phyllis always says to Persa, do you want a cup of tea and a book?
Phyllis, you've definitely got competition there, Chuck, haven't you? Mind you, if I were a mother, I'd be a bit worried. I really would. Now, in the back of those shots of the kids, you might have noticed that, you know, they did a little bit of painting. All the pictures of their favourites, of their street characters. Look at this. Look at that. Ah, oh, isn't that sweet? Now, who's that got to be? I think it's you, Derek. Where's Derek? Yes, Derek, that's got to be you, sweetheart. Who else have we got? Oh, have a guess. That's our Deirdre. It's the glasses that give it away, Chuck. It really is. Now, no guess who that is. The beautiful, better self, all the glamour there, those lovely, luscious lips. Ooh, they haven't changed. But we're a bit bemused by this. No, we're open to offers, actually, who this one is, actually. Anybody, any ideas who this one is? Pardon? No, personally, I think it's our Alec Gilroy myself. I really do. But they were all lovely pictures and all lovely children, don't you agree? I think they deserve a big round of applause. Great. You know, when you look back over 30 years, there have been a lot of parties thrown in the street. In fact, at one party in 1977 in the community centre, a disc jockey called Dave the Rave made his first appearance. And you'll have no trouble recognising him. He's not changed a bit.
What I'm saying is, why can't we have a Velita?
Because nobody's asked me, that's why. I'd rather like a Velita.
Well, why can't he have a Velita if he wants one?
Yeah, we were told there'd be something for everybody. We're not all still sweet 16, you know.
Well, I'd noticed that, actually.
Let's say a big hidey-hi to Paul Shane. Well, you must have some very fond memories of the street.
I have a very soft spot for Coronation Street. We'll always have a corner of my heart because Jimmy Perry was actually watching Coronation Street when I was doing that, and he had me down to read for Ted Bovis, and I got the part. So, I mean, that scene, really, you can say, that 40, 45 seconds changed my life overnight, which was fantastic. Thank you, Coronation Street.
Oh.
And I'd just like to say hello to the gang because I know a lot. I go back with Lynn and Liz and all the, most of these people for about 30 years on the Northern Clubs. It's lovely to see you, my friends. God bless you. 30 years, let's hope it 100 years. I love you dearly, all of you. God bless you.
Nice. Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Shane.
Bye-bye.
Enjoy the talk.
God bless you.
Our next guest is a comedian who is just as funny sitting in a chair as he is standing up. In fact, sometimes when he is standing up, people still think he's sitting in a chair. He's one of Coronation Street's biggest admirers. Here he is, as you've never seen him before. Ladies and gentlemen, Ronnie Corbett.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Silla, for drawing attention to the suit. I was hoping they wouldn't notice. It is not my idea to dress up as a waiter. I'll tell you that. They said, you wear the tux or you can't go to the party, but it has been worth it. 5 minutes ago, I was dancing cheek to cheek with Bette Gilroy. And... well, it was cheek to cheek until someone kicked the box away. And I... after that, the view was wonderful, but I couldn't hear the band. But anyway, I'm sorry. The old ones are the best. I'm actually very lucky, to be honest, to have this suit. It's been hanging in the closet so long that my wife threw it out last week and the moths brought it back in again. And the moths have actually applied for a home improvement grant. Good. Good heavens. I haven't worn... I might lean back. No, I think I'll stay well. Good heavens. I haven't worn this suit since me and Hilda Baker were standing on top of Irma Barlow's wedding cake. I digress. What I was actually going to tell you is that today does bring back an extra special memory for me. On this day, 25 years ago, when my dear, lovely wife... Sorry, Anne. That's right, sorry. turned to me at the altar and whispered those four unforgettable words. Your flies are undone. Unfortunately, my wife cannot be with us tonight because of a slight misunderstanding. She apparently thought I said this party was in Granada, not at Granada. And she left on the 4 o'clock from Gatwick. Anyway, which is rather a pity because she's always been a very ardent fan of Coronation Street. Good heavens, there was a time when we couldn't make love without a picture of Albert Tatlock in the ceiling. Now, anyway, what I was actually going to say was that because of this 30th anniversary, I have gone to a lot of trouble to find a 30-year-old joke to tell. Now, you're probably thinking this is a pathetic excuse to tell an old chestnut. Although, of course, you may not be thinking that at all. I mean, you may be thinking something entirely different, you know. You may be thinking, when Kojak shaves, where does he actually start? Or you may be thinking, how did that crowd in the Rovers Return manage to drink all night and never go out for a pee? I thought that one. But for those of you who are still with me, here is the joke, which I hope I can remember, because I haven't told it, I'll be honest, since I opened our village fete the other week in aid of the church roof, which has deteriorated almost beyond repair since it was built way back in the early part of last year. And... the fate was actually the inspiration of our new trendy vicar, the Reverend Kevin, who's actually since been unfrocked owing to an incident at his drive-in Evensong. When the butcher's wife ran over his foot, he maintains he told her to back off. And I wasn't there at the time, but we're going to miss him. I will remember the last time I met him in our local, that's why we called him our local vicar. He was always in the local. And I remember that night particularly because he blessed the landlady who went into a trance and gave two customers the right change. After which she got him to bless the fruit machine and it didn't pay out for a fortnight. Somebody's giving me a bit of a signal off there. It's a little bit confusing, you know. When you're going on too long at the BBC, they go like that. Up here at Granada, they go like that, you know. So, much more civilized. So I'll press on with the joke, which concerns a poor old lady who lives in a tower block with nobody for company but her parrot. Could have been worse. She could have got Percy Sugden. Anyway, so this day, she is going shopping and she says, "Now, don't forget, Polly, if anyone knocks, you shout, 'Who is it?' so that they won't think the place is empty and break in and nick my video and my inflatable Mike Baldwin." So, no sooner has she gone out, then along comes the insurance man. He knocks at the door. The parrot says, "Who is it?" Fairly pathetic parrot, that was, I thought. Anyway, "Who is it?" The insurance man leans through the letterbox. He says, "It's the insurance man." The parrot goes, "Who is it?" "It's the insurance man." "Who is it?" The insurance. This goes on forever and ever. Out of frustration, eventually, added to the fact that the poor insurance man has had a long climb up the stairs that I forgot to mention. It's too much for the poor old fellow, and he collapses on the landing. A short while later, the lady returns and sees him lying there. She goes, "Who is it?" The parrot goes, "It's the insurance man."
Well, thanks a lot, Ronnie. It's lovely to see you again. Now, there's nothing more guaranteed to set the tongues wagging in the Rovers than the fur. And Deirdre Barlow's fling with Mike Baldwin not only set the tongues wagging, but also gave the street one of its biggest audiences ever. The stormy marriage of Ken and Deirdre Barlow has produced some of the street's most dramatic and most touching moments.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this congregation to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. It is commended in holy writ to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not to be enterprised nor taken in hand unadvisedly, lightly, or wantonly.
You must be mistaken. It couldn't have been. You couldn't have seen yesterday. He's doing something up in Baltimore now. I hate when he's away. You must be mistaken. I'm sure that you are. There's more than one cup with stickers on, and lots of young guys wear corduroy pants, and I'd know if he hadn't gone.
There and then,
well, my farewell and pray.
thank you to the lovely Marty Webb. It was a gorgeous song, that, wasn't it?
Yes!
In fact, it could have been written for Ken and Deirdre, couldn't it?
Yes!
Now, you know, for almost 25 years, Annie Walker ruled the roost at the Rovers and was a leading member of the Lady Victualers Association. So grand. And from 1962, her rival at the Laughing Donkey was Nellie Harvey.
Cheers. You and Arthur going to Morecambe again this year, Nellie? Right, you're having a change. I always think a place begins to pall after the 10th or 11th visit.
Well, we were looking at the Greek islands, actually.
Oh, really?
Only it's the heat, you know. It brings Arthur's hands out like puddings.
Yes, here she is, but without that shocking pink hat, ladies and gentlemen, Molly Sugden! Oh, Molly, it's lovely to see you here tonight. I bet you had a lot of fun times on the street, didn't you?
Oh, yes, and it's such an honour to be invited to come here tonight. But you know, Sheila, I think that a lot of people who've been associated with the street know that there are certain members of the public who are inclined to say, oh, I never watch Coronation Street. And yet they're always up to date with the plot.
I know.
They always know what's going on. Now, quite some time ago, my husband played Cyril Turpin in Coronation Street, you know, the policeman. And I was at home in our village. I was going down to the shops, and a lady came up to me and stopped me. Now, I didn't know who she was, but obviously she knew who I was. And she said, what's your husband doing now? So I said, oh, he's in Coronation Street. She said, oh, I never watched that. So I said, well, what does your husband do? She said, well, he's manager of our local bank. So I said, oh, I never banked there.
Oh, that's lovely. And what about that terrible pink hat that you were wearing? Did you enjoy wearing that?
I can't honestly remember, but I do know that Nellie Harvey always had some terrible hats on.
Did you? Yes. Well, we can't let you go. We've got a little surprise for you. Yes, we dug deep in the archives of our wardrobe. We've got that hat for you now.
I don't believe it.
Yes, Christmas has come early, and here it is. And it looks gorgeous on you. You can wear it for the rest of the party and enjoy it too. Ladies and gentlemen, Molly Sugden. Still to come on our street celebration, we have our live link up with Wembley, some of the street's most dramatic moments, and a lot more familiar faces.
Hi, I'm Nicole Dixon from Home and Away, and all of us here would like to congratulate Coronation Street on your 30th birthday.
Yeah, that's a great effort, guys. You know, we haven't got one cast member who's reached age 30.
True.
Well, with the possible exception of Norman. No, it's a great effort, and we'd like to wish you a
happy birthday, Coronation Street!
You walk, you talk, you're who you think you are. Street life.
tango. Street life is the only life I know. Street life, but you'd better not get old. Street life, or you're gonna feel the cold. Oh!
Back outside on the street at number three. I wonder what surprises lay in store here. Oh, it's Kevin Lloyd and Peter Ellis from The Bill.
Hi, Kevin.
Smashing. Kevin, welcome back to the street.
Thank you very much.
What part did you play?
Well, I played a very young version of Don Watkins. He was manager of the graffiti club for Mike Baldwin. I think I still owe Mike £5,000. I've got to check here, so you're all right.
What part did you play, Chuck?
I started off playing a policeman about 15 years ago, and about eight parts later, I was a villain. And,
oh, really? Yeah, that was good training for The Bill, wasn't it?
Well, Betty Turpin, yes, that was it. That was the end.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy yourself?
Oh, it was fantastic. Yeah. Great memories, great times.
And we've got a long night ahead as well. Enjoy the rest of the party. See you later.
Happy birthday, Coronation Street, from The Bill. Thank
you. See you later.
Bye-bye.
I wonder who's here. I'm enjoying this. Oh, hello. Surprise, surprise. It's Fraser Hines and Arthur Pentelow. Welcome back to the street.
Thank you.
Now, Arthur, tell everybody's dying to know, what part did you play?
In 1968, more years ago than I care to remember, I played George Greenwood, who was a park keeper who had a mild flirtation with Hilda Upton.
Never mind, Fraser. I believe you had a mild flirtation with a certain lady as well.
Yes, I was one of Lucille Hewitt's boyfriends. Or a guy called Roger, but he was a wimp. He wore all the straight clothes. Everybody else wearing way out 60s swinging flared gear and everything. Did all the latest dances. Roger was doing the twist. So I got fan letters from girls saying, we've gone right off you, Fraser, because we didn't realise you danced so horribly. So I left.
Oh, what a shame. You left and you went into Emmerdale Farm. I must say, I love Emmerdale Farm. It's the only fresh air I get. Are you enjoying yourself?
Oh, yeah,
yes,
love it.
Thank you.
Have a good night. See you later. Hang on. I recognise this face. Harry Cross. Oh, yes, from Brookside.
Yes, but I was the postman on Coronation Street 20 years ago, and it was a much better service.
Was it really?
It was indeed.
Well, I know Bill. Bill's your real name. You've got a special tribute to say to all the gang, haven't you?
Well, what can I say about Coronation Street? I've watched it for 30 years, still watching it, and if the Lord spares me, I'll watch it for the next 60 years.
Oh, isn't that kind? I think that's lovely.
Lovely to see you, Silla.
You too.
Lovely to see a fellow Scouser and a fellow Evertonian.
Get off. See you later. Now the Rover's returned. This is it. This is what I've been waiting for all night. I wonder who's in here. Oh, and it's Michael Mealy and Peter Dean.
Silla, how are you?
Michael.
All right.
What part did you play in the street?
I played a policeman called Sergeant Cummings, and I came up the first time and I had to sort out when the heavy goods truck crashed into the Rover's Return. I had to sort all that. I was first on the scene, and then I went back to London. They brought me up again to sort out the riot in Johnny Briggs' factory. Then I went back to London and they brought me back up again as Sergeant Cummings to sort out a kidnapping of a child.
Yes.
And so I was backwards and forwards all the time, and I was known after that as Sergeant Cummings and Goings.
Oh, bless. What about, you haven't said much, Pete. What part did you play?
I played a character called Fangio Bates, who supposed to be a randy lorry driver. Never got much to play of the part, but that was my character in it, yes.
Well, actually, I must say I love EastEnders as well. Thank you both very much for dressing up. I can't believe it. Will you enjoy the rest of the evening?
Yeah. Hopefully, yeah.
Hoping to see some.
I shall see you later. Oh, you will indeed. I shall see you later.
Thanks very much.
Well, now, every family on every street has its ups and its downs. It's good times and it's bad. And the families on this street are no exception. In fact, the street has had more than enough drama to keep us all on the edge of our seats all over these years. thanks to some terrific writing and some truly memorable performances. Just take a look at this.
Just tell me what it is, what you want. Just tell us what it'll take to get us on the right track. Marriage? If you want marriage, I'll marry you. I don't need you. I can't go on up here. I've seen the future, it terrifies me. I don't want a loser.
No, I know.
I try to be Christian, but there's something wrong with me. I can't see other people sometimes. I can't seem to see when they need help. It was my daughter, she had that tumour, you know, and all I could do was shout at her and holler at her.
Yes, one of them. Well, now, you just sit there and I'm out.
I'm frightened. I'm frightened she's dead. He's been taken away from us, love. He has been taken away from us.
I know, Mum. Come on, I'll take you home.
I'm getting depressed.
You'd be more depressed if you was working.
Churches always do that to me.
Yeah. That's because you know he's giving you the once-over and not liking what he sees.
Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder.
I want to know where you've been and who with. Oh, is it serious? I went from nothing to nothing. Wasn't very easy. But it wasn't very hard.
You're not nothing.
Oh, no. No. I'm a bit of stuff. I'm a cheap thrill now like I was then. Come on, Eddie. That's what you were after. You and Len and a busload of others, if I could name them. But you're all quick out that door if I should stop laughing.
Mavis?
Come in, it's not locked.
Come on, come on.
You're all right,
She still says she can't.
I can't, I just can't go in there.
Oh, no.
Can I stay here with you, please, Rita? I mean, would you mind?
Of course I don't mind. You can stay as long as you like, as far as I'm concerned. You're going to have to go in there sometime, you know.
Not tonight. I can't go in tonight. I tried.
Well, we got as far as the front door.
Go any further. Oh, love. Oh, sure.
I don't know what to do. Can somebody tell me? Because I just don't know what else I can do.
People like me don't marry people like him, except in boxes.
Oh, yes, he could have married anyone.
He could. His mother told me when she was over last time, she said he was the most eligible bachelor.
That's right, he had everything. Money, looks, good family, brains.
Yes.
So the stupid Burke has to marry some grotty old has-been from the wrong side of the tracks.
What did you say?
Well, didn't he?
Get out!
What, Mr. Superman? And that? Well, I ask you.
Go on then,
Ape, do what the hell you like.
We did enough thing. Oh, what was that?
Stanley Ogden, will you tell me just what you was doing out all night with Elsie Tanner?
You won't believe me if
I tell you. Never mind that. You just tell me and we'll see if I believe you or not.
I played chuckstones.
Chuckstones? Chuckstones?
Ah, it were quite fun too.
I'm sure it was.
Oh, wasn't that moody? Well, you can all put your hankies away now and settle down, because the Rovers have seen staff come and go over the past 30 years. But tonight, we're very privileged because we might be seeing a new and voluptuous character joining the cast of The Street. It all depends on whether or not she lands a job in the Rovers.
The cooking ranch, the cooking ranch, the cooking ranch, the cooking ranch, the cooking ranch.
I'm sorry, I'm not strictly open yet, love.
I must say, Mother, your face is very familiar.
Really?
You're the dead spit of a great friend of mine.
Oh, yeah?
You haven't got a younger sister called Sissy, have you? She's a wonderful woman. She lives in Gatley now. She's come down in the world. And she was a great friend of mine. A nicer body never broke the day's bread. Well, she was always very bay-windowed in those days. She'd done well for us. And she suffered like any woman. For years she had creeping alopecia and water retention. Perhaps she knew her husband, Leonard. Stiff little fellow with a wall eye.
Oh, did he work on the council?
Yes, for years. He used to take photographs of people with one of those instant things.
Yeah. Polaroids.
Oh, he had those for years. In winter, he walked with a hopping motion.
Yeah. No. Anyway, sit yourself down. What can I do for you?
Well, it's... it's just... it's a bit of trouble with me, gusset. Well, that woman from Rosamond Street... said you might be taking on extra staff holiday.
What woman's this?
The one with the veins and the neck brace. From number 42, you know the house with the dirty tools and the spade Rottweiler.
I knew years ago at the ritual I could tell you some stories about that woman. During the war, she had more soldiers than Eisenhower. You couldn't get in the bedroom for gum wrappers.
Well, I'm afraid I don't go in for sordid, speculative prattle.
Oh, you're getting plenty of tone then, are you?
You've met the wife then, haven't you? Yes, now about this position of barmaid.
Yes.
Are you cognizant with the licensed trade?
I get a lot of wind with Guinness.
You're misconstruing.
I know, I sweat like a pig in Benidorm.
I'm sorry, I'm afraid you're not suitable at all. I mean, not being disrespectful, but I was looking for a much younger woman.
Are you suggesting that I'm over the hill?
No, but you've a damn good view of the valley.
Well, I'll have you know, I'm only 43 and some months.
How many months?
57. All I'm asking is an opportunity to... I can clean. I used to... the garment long bag years ago. I was the best scrubber they ever had. Yeah. I can help out behind the bar. I can cook. I can anything you want.
Yes, well, I can't promise anything, but I'll take a few particulars down. Now, what's your name, Luke?
Oh, it's Shufflebottom.
Shufflebottom, yeah.
Ada Bernice.
Ada Bernice. Ada Bernice.
Named after my grandmother. Ada Bernice. Ada. Victoria Shufflebottom.
Yeah. Shufflebottom.
Shufflebottom. Two Fs.
Right. So, with regards to this position, then, I already have a cook, you know.
Oh, have you?
Yes, yes, a Betty. Betty, a thousand and one ways with minced turpin.
Oh.
And she's not quite as adept as she used to be.
Oh, really?
No, no, no. I had a complaint from a customer only last week.
Oh, so
found her corn plaster in her con carne.
Oh, God help her. She must have been bending the wrong way.
So do you think you could manage to do
a bit
of cooking?
I could do a bit of
foreign stuff. I'm interested in, you know, more esoteric meals in the bar, you know.
Yes.
You know, like curries, for instance.
Very nice.
What's your vindaloo like?
Well, it's plain white towels and a wooden seat.
No, look, do you think you could manage cock au vin?
Well, my husband asked me to try it once. I scraped my knees on the gear stick.
I'm sorry, you've just been fatuous.
No, I smelt it when I came in. say they're nice bar mats, aren't they?
Put that down, that's Percy Sugden's script. Oh.
I know who you are.
Ah, so it's all a ruse, is it? A hoax. You're a fan, really, are you?
Who have it, he is. Ever since the programme started, I've never missed one episode. And God knows I've had my troubles. I mean, I've had everything. And I love that signature song. La 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 la.
That's the Archers. This is Coronation Street.
Oh, I never watched that crap.
Well, there she was, Ada Shufflebottom, better known as Les Dawson, and of course the lovely Roy Barraclough. Oh, absolutely wonderful. Now, as the street celebrated its 28th birthday, we were all very actually sad, because one of its best-loved characters unravelled her rollers and moved away. And I'll tell you this, if he would have had her in the Eurovision Song Contest, we would have won hands down every year.
We've been together now for 40 years, and it don't seem fair.
Hilda! Will you stop making that row?
All right, so I'm not no Mariah Callas. But if I want to sing, I'll sing.
How do you know?
Well, it's obvious. You've only got to look at the outside. Windows that thick with muck, you can't see through them. And Elsie Turner, roaming round the house with a wild look in her eye and her hair streaming down her back like someone demented. Just repeat that again.
I don't boil my cabbages twice. Not unless you're going deaf in your old age.
Oh, look at the mess. I told you that chimney wanted sweeping.
You've done me sweeping now. Look at me. Look at the mess. Look at me dinner.
Never mind your dinner. Look at me Muriel. Me mountain's turned into a slaggy.
Isn't that all right for you?
Oh, could I see, please?
Back to you.
Yes, thank you. I think that'll be very pleasant.
You're learning.
Yeah, could get used to this very quick.
What's that lipstick taste of?
Woman, Stanley. Woman.
Ladies and gentlemen, that wonderful award-winning actress, Jean Alexander. Oh, Jean, look at that. You see that standing ovation? It's lovely actually being here. You know, we all miss you. We really do miss you.
It's brilliant. It's made me all nervous now.
Ah, do you actually miss the street? I'm sure you do.
Yes, I do. I miss all my friends over there very much. But it's nice to see everybody again. I've got some marvellous happy memories
I'm
of
sure
being
you are.
Here.
What one about little rehearsals? They must have been fun.
Yeah, well, one little funny thing came to mind while I was standing out there. It concerns dear Jack Howarth, who played Albert Tatlock. Now, Jack was very, very fond of donuts. And when we were in studio, between the dress rehearsal and the recording, we used to go and have tea in a side room, and there were plates of cakes arranged along the table for anybody that wanted them. Well, Bernard and I, one afternoon, we finished our scenes before most of the other people, and we strolled along to the tea room. And just as we were going in, Bernard said, "Just a minute, look." And we looked through the glass panel in the door, and there was little Jack, scuttling up the table, picking out all the donuts off the plates and putting them in his pockets. Well, just as he got to the last plate, Bernard said, "Come on, let's go in." So we went in, and Jack whipped round and stood there like a little hamster with his pockets full of donuts. And he said to me, "You like donuts, don't you?" I said, "Yes, Jack." He said, "Well, there's one there. You better get it before anybody else comes in."
Oh, lovely memories. Yeah, look at the set, though, Jean. Look at the ducks up there. Doesn't it make you all nostalgic?
Gosh, yes. Yes, that one never did lie straight.
A
Jean, I've got to ask you, what? Just for old time's sake, because I thought you sang ever so well up there. Could you give us, before you go, could you give us a quick burst of the old Ilda? Could you do that for us? Yes? Yes.
Cilla, you know there's a notice in theatres that says, this theatre can be cleared in 3 minutes if the audience leave in an orderly manner. Well, I guarantee I could shift them in one.
Oh, no, no.
Just risk it?
Yes, please. The hills are alive with the sound of music.
Oh, God!
Ladies and gentlemen, Jean Alexander, that's marvelous. Well, we'll be back for more party surprises, plus our live link to Wembley and Cliff Richard after the break. Ooh, can't wait.
Oh, it's great.
Welcome back to the party. Now, here's someone waiting to say a very special happy birthday from London. We are now going over live to the Wembley Arena, where we should see my old my old mate Cliff Richard. Are you there, Cliff? There he is. Oh, look at that.
Yes, Cilla.
Hi, Cliff. You know, it's Coronation Street's 30th birthday. Oh, yes.
There's a motley crew with me.
I know. How many's there tonight, Cliff?
Well, we're a little bit short because the blizzard caught some people on the hop, so they couldn't quite make it. But I guess there must be 11,500 people.
Oh, gosh. Cliff, it's the 30th anniversary, as you know, of Coronation Street. That's why I'm here. And I believe you had a birthday this year too, didn't you, Chuck?
Yes, darling. I was 35.
Well, actually, the way you're looking, I can believe you. Now, I must say that Coronation Street started in December 1960, and you were having your fourth number one hit at the time. Do you remember it?
I do, yeah. It was written by Bruce Welch called, and Cilla, I love you.
Oh, Cliff, I'm ever so flattered. I really am. Should have been a secret, really, though. Can you give us a few bars? How did it go? Remind everyone how it went.
I love you. I want you for my own. Your love means so much more. More than anything I've ever known. Well, everyone knows one and one is two. I'm the one and the other one's you. So let's get together and you will see how much I love you. Let's get together and you will see how much I love you.
You've been a lifelong fan of Coronation Street, haven't you, Chuck?
I've always loved Coronation Street. It changed my life, Cilla, let's face it.
Well, how's that? Tell us more.
Well, I mean, I was watching it one time, way back, probably it must have been a year into it or something, and they gave me one of those honorary mentions, you know, but they called me chubby. So I went on a diet. I've been on it since.
Oh, well, I bet you thought, surprise, surprise, Cliff. I bet you thought that episode was lost forever, didn't you?
I was hoping it had been burnt. Oh, no, come on.
Well, it hasn't. We've dug that one out as well. Just have a look at this.
That band's gone out of tune.
Hey, nay.
Nay, now, I'll have you know, I've got perfect pitch. Low end grin. It's funny, you know, but here folks talk these days, everything begun and ended with Annie, get your gun.
Oh, you can't beat the old tunes, though, can you?
Oh, I don't know. Have you never heard West Side Story on Sandy MacPherson?
Aye, but it doesn't seem the same thing somehow. Isn't Cliff Richard a lovely, chubby lad?
Oh, Cliff, they couldn't say that now, though, could they, Chuck? You look gorgeous now, and you had a number one, didn't you?
Yes, I did
when
then,
yeah. When Coronation Street started.
Yes.
That was 30 years ago.
I know.
And I know you're poised and set to have another number one hit record.
Oh, Cilla, I got fingers crossed.
Yeah. And we're all dying, I know Wembley are absolutely dying to hear, but we're all dying to hear it here, too. Will you sing Saviour's Day for us?
Yeah, of course I will.
being with us, and we wish you a lot of luck with that one. In fact, a lot of luck.
Silly, listen, we haven't finished. We got a surprise for you.
Have you?
Yep.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Coronation Street. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, wasn't that smashing though? And he looks so young. Makes you sick, doesn't it? It really does. Now, the cornerstone of Coronation Street has always been the Rover's return. Our final birthday guest as landlady with her husband Jack laid the foundations of a legend which continues today with Bette and Alec Gilroy at the helm. She handed over the keys of the Rovers in 1984 after 24 memorable and most wonderful year.
It is customary to kneel.
Some people get right into the part, don't they?
Well, she's been rehearsing all her life.
You can't rehearse, Majesty, Mr. Tetlock. It's either something you've got or you haven't.
Will you stop nagging? I'm worn out and I want to get to sleep.
You're worn out? You're worn out? Who was it who made 4 dozen sausage rolls, 8 dozen assorted fingers, 3...
Well, nobody asked you to.
Are you going downstairs?
Once and for all, I...
Do you mind keeping your voices down? We're supposed to be having a party downstairs.
Well, that's very kind of you, Eva.
You have a beautiful voice.
It's no better than yours. I've heard your Rock of Ages echoing across the street on a Sunday morning.
I do my best.
Oh, put some folk behind a booze of Abba think they're Queen Mother, don't they? Oh, present company exonerated, of course. No, what I'm implying is, if you'll take my advice, Mrs. Walker, you'll keep that one well away from Mr. Walker.
Mrs. Ogden, to the best of my belief, I have never taken your advice in anything. And I'm certainly not going to start now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Doris Speed. Goes on and on. Goes on and on. Ah. Oh. Doris, isn't this a wonderful evening for you?
Well, they must be very nice people to make such a fuss of me.
Ah.
They must be very intuitive people.
Well, I don't know what that means, Doris.
I'll explain to you afterwards. What I wanted to tell you is that I've been watching it all, of course, and it seems such a long time since I had my audition. And I was very thrilled when I was accepted, of course, and I went home to tell my mother, who herself had been on the boards all her life, practically, and never made any decent money. Well, that was true. Anyhow, I said, oh, Mother, I've got it. And it's for 3 weeks. And I said, there's just a possibility that there might be an option of a further 2 weeks. And I said, I am getting £50 a week.
Ah, oh, isn't that lovely? Well, Doris...
And Mother said, well, I'm sorry, dear, but I have to say it. You're not worth it.
Well, you know, we couldn't end this marvellous birthday celebration of 30 years of the street without welcoming onto the stage, to join Doris, the foundations of the next 30 years and beyond. Ladies and gentlemen, the stars of Coronation Street. Well, I'm enjoying this. Yeah. As one famous lady said, before we go, there is one more surprise, and a very, very special one. Amongst the thousands of birthday cards and best wishes that arrived today, there was this one, and it says it all. It's from Buckingham Palace and Her Majesty the Queen. Best wishes to the cast of Coronation Street and to all those concerned with the production for an enjoyable and successful celebration gala. Oh. The Queen, how about that? Well, isn't that marvellous? Congratulations. Thank
you very much. Oh, thank you. I'll do that. That's wonderful.
Super. Lovely. We shall see you all again in another 30 years. Until then, good night. God bless you all. Good night.
Good night.